And here we go, our research question. Now, we're going to come up with a fake little project. In other words, we're not going to collect any real patient data, and we're going to really oversimplify things. This is really going to be the low-hanging fruit that we're going to pluck just to form a basis for you to work from. Now, in many instances, institutions are resource constrained. We don't all live in a fancy first world ivory tower sort of situation. But these are really the basics from which any kind of project can be built. And if you have these down, you can really start doing your own medical research. So we're going to draw a sample set of patients from a population admitted with skin and soft tissue infections due to diabetes mellitus. So these patients have problems with their insulin regulation, their sugar levels go up in their blood, and they develop all sorts of infections. So we have our make-believe little hospital, and we admit patients. Admission criteria is that they must have diabetes, and they are admitted because they have some infection, either skin or soft tissue infection. Now, we're going to classify these infections into two groups. To do that, we do have to have a definition. We don't have to be rigorous about it. Yeah, I just want to set up two groups to compare to each other. And we're just going to call them, for argument's sake, minor infection and major infection. We could say that all the minor infections would be someone who's just admitted short term, who's just getting some local dressings on their infection, on their skin infection, getting oral antibiotics. And we could say that the definition of major infection would be that they require intravenous antibiotics or some form of surgical intervention, cleaning the wound surgically. When we do a proper medical research, we have to be very proper about these definitions though. But for argument's sake here, we have two groups and we're going to compare various variables between these two groups. We've got to define them. And what are our questions going to be? Well, we come up with these as clinicians, as we do ward rounds, as we see patients. As I'm a surgeon, as I take patients to surgery, you start wondering about things. You think, I wonder if there's a difference there. I wonder if I were to do things differently. I read something in the literature and that might make me think of doing something differently, something new. Thought processes that occur other than just the normal care of the patients. So our research question here is really going to be very simple. We're going to compare the difference between these two groups that we formed, minor infections, major infections. Between these two groups, we're going to compare the admission HbA1c and the admission CRP. So in case you don't know, HbA1c is a marker in a patient's blood, really tells us how good their blood sugar level control has been in the recent past. And CRP stands for C-reactive protein. It's a marker in the blood. Both of these can be tested in the laboratory by a blood sample. CRP is a marker for infection or inflammation. And absolute values are not necessarily that helpful to us as clinicians, and we really care about the trend. So if we do serial analysis and the CRP level starts coming down, we know we are on top of the inflammation or the infection. As it starts rising, we are concerned and we might do further investigation, even further surgery, change our management in some way. But the absolute value is not necessarily that crucial. But if you have two patients and one and both of them have a CRP of 50, they might have very different severity of the infection. So it's not the absolute value. So just that we're clear about what HbA1c and CRP really means. So in the context of this little project here, we're just using them as surrogate variables that we can collect data points on and do our analysis. So a nice little research project here. It's not a real-world project. We're not collecting any real-world examples. And the question that I'm asking here is perhaps not really of any clinical significance, but it's real nice data to work with, and we've got our two groups defined. We can do our analysis. Now, the next step is going to be to go to the literature and do a search and see what others have published on this topic on these research questions.